Howdy folks, David Gonzalez here. Happy New Year. It is 2019. And with the pending release of Blender 2.8, I've been thinking a lot about where I want to take this channel. The inspiration for this video came from when I was cleaning out the video logs of like some of the game stuff and just trying to like make it more Blender specific. I ran into the first video that we ever did, which was the sculpt of Catherine Keys here, Carmen Gemini, and like I know there's this thing of like, you know, just resculpting, redoing work that you did previously. So I just wanted to see like how much my sculpting technique has improved. Now the previous video, the one from the first video from 2 years ago, that was done in Sculptress. This is all done in Blender. I'm almost kind of tempted to go back into Sculptress and do it in Sculptress just to see if the environment changes anything. I'm not really sure, but the end result was a bit shocking to the point where I'm almost kind of wondering what I was thinking 2 years ago. This was a difficult task, believe it or not, and really I think the biggest takeaway I took from this is that I need to keep working. Like, I have to do stuff. So even if I'm not working specifically towards Legend of Legendary Legends, that to keep doing something, anything, just to keep the technique up. It was very difficult to start this. I tried doing a live stream the last day, you know, December 31st, you know, the last day of 2018. I wanted to do this, and I tried a live stream, and it wound up horrible. I deleted this model like 5 times. I tried so many different ways to start it, and each way that I started just wasn't, like, I wasn't getting anywhere, you know, I wasn't really making any headway with it. So, and I don't think specifically that it was just trying to acclimate to sculpting in Blender. I have done Blender sculpts before. The point that I'm trying to get across is that it was a me thing. It wasn't a 2.8 thing. So I feel that the transition from 2.8 to 2.7 is going to be relatively painless. It's not that big of a deal. Yeah, I don't really feel that it's that big of a deal changing from Blender 2.8 to from Blender 2.79 to Blender 2.8. I mean, it's not as big as a shock if you were using Softimage, and then Softimage gets canned by Autodesk, and so you had to switch to Maya. That was pretty crazy. And I remember when I was in school, ours was the last class to actually learn Softimage, and we wound up, it softened the blow a bit because we wound up learning Softimage and Maya at the same time. It was interesting. Like, the first semester was done in Softimage, or not the first semester. Was it the first semester done in Softimage? I'm trying to remember how our teacher did it. We did wind up learning Softimage and Maya at the same time. So no, it wasn't that jarring going from, you know, Blender 2.79 to Blender 2.8 is not as jarring as going from Softimage to Maya. And interestingly enough, when I was looking at some of the videos online about pipelines and how to create a production environment in Blender, a lot of the people were saying that that was actually kind of a wake-up call for them when Autodesk just dropped the support for Softimage. So now you had like these different studios that now had to, you know, not only fork over the money to buy all the Maya licenses, but that they also had to, you know, instruct their team, you know, and find ways of getting their team to move from Softimage to Maya. So all in all, 2.8 I'm very excited about. And being that it's been 2 years since I started doing this, I've learned a lot myself, not just in terms of Blender, but in terms of how to make videos. And so there's videos that I have where the sound quality is absolutely garbage. With 2.8 closely coming out to its final release, it's now in open beta. And from everything that I've been reading, it's pretty stable. So I'm guessing this open beta now is just basically the stress test for it. So they're saying it's not going to change much. So those previous videos where the sound quality was terrible. I'm not gonna beat around the bush here. I'm not gonna try to say it was iffy. The sound quality was terrible. So with those videos, I'll be doing those videos over again with 2.8. I don't anticipate much of the workflow from 2.7 to 2.8 being that different. I will break the videos up into smaller segments because most of those videos were running in about an hour. So instead, I'll be looking for like 15 to 20 minute videos instead of the hour video. Also because it helps in terms of transcribing the videos. It's just these shorter doses of video would be easier to transcribe. So I hope you guys enjoy this little exercise. 2019, I'm excited for it, and we'll see where it goes. What I'm definitely going to be trying to do is to get further into Legend of Legendary Legends. No, the title is not for debate, and it is not a working title. It will be the official title of the series. So the first thing that I will be doing is working on kind of, not an animatic, but how Blizzard did with the Warbringers series, the Daughter of the Sea, and the Ashara one. I'll be looking at doing something like that for Medusa, just to solidify all the different mythologies of Medusa into a cohesive backstory that I'll be using for this particular story. So, if you guys like what I'm doing here, please subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and make sure you hit the bell icon for further notifications. I'm going to try to increase how regularly I'm coming up with content. I'm going to try to at least come up with weekly content. If you guys can help me grow this channel, share the channel with your friends and get them to subscribe as well. Even if I hit the 1,000 mark, again, in respect to the community that Blender's trying to build, this channel will not be monetized. But this also means that if I'm not monetized, Google doesn't have a vested interest in pushing my content. So any growth that we'll see with this channel really is going to be coming from you guys. So if you guys can really give me a hand here, share the channel with your friends, get your friends to subscribe, and I'll keep the content coming. I got to a limit as to how much detail I can push on the model, and it became increasingly clear that if I wanted any more detail, like pores or wrinkles and stuff, that I was going to have to retopologize the model to do it, because I had to apply maps. So here I'm going through the different steps for the retopology. And then it dawns on me that I'm essentially redoing the entire thing. Like, I'm redoing this entire model. And that was a little bit out of scope for what I wanted in this particular exercise. I just wanted to see how my basic sculpting skills improved from 2 years ago to now. So once I finally realized that, I stopped doing the retopology. And I just basically imported the model from 2 years ago, just to give a side-by-side comparison. And there it is on the right-hand side, and I don't for the life of me know what I was thinking. It's such a bizarre difference, like night and day. It's like almost, I can't believe that there was the same model, you know, like I came to two very different conclusions from the same source material, and that was just odd. Share the channel with your friends, get your friends to subscribe, and I'll keep the content flowing. Happy 2019, folks.